we get to the bottom of the tough issues here.
Yes.
Like, when is Fat Tuesday? When is Easter?
Easter is known as a movable feast because it doesn't have a set date.
That's a very good point. Yeah.
Right.
As opposed to when my daughter once said, what date does Christmas fall on this year? she was young at the time.
Yes, the 4th of July and Independence Day typically fall on the same day.
Ah, right. Yeah, kind of fits there, that 4th
of
July.
I'm glad Mary was in here today. I didn't know all this.
Thank you, Mary, for setting us all straight here this morning. Otherwise, we would all be lost. You have a pretty cool, you're from Munson Williams.
Yes.
And we were there, who was the performance?
Oh, yes.
Oh, that was so good.
The trumpeter.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was
great.
Wow,
that was incredible. Bria. She's is she from New York, I believe, the city, and came up with her band. It was really, really good.
I'm so glad you went.
February 9th through April 7th, so getting underway this week, is Tommy Brown, who is an upstate photographer from Norwich. Talk about this.
That's right. Tommy was born in Norwich, and he went to Colgate University. He lived in New York City. He got his Master's of Fine Arts at Yale University. So widely traveled, but returned to his hometown area and has lived upstate for the past 30, 40 years, raised his family here, but has continued to make pictures the whole time. So he has created several different bodies of work, but I was particularly interested in the images from Chenango and Madison County because of their relevance to our audiences here. And they are beautiful.
And what are his photos typically?
In this particular exhibition, we have portraits of farmers and kids who live. We have beautiful landscape at all different times of year. Stunning. Quite.
So does this show the does it show the positive side?
Oh, yes.
Or does it show, because as you drive through, you know, Otsego, all of our upstate New York area, you see barns that used to be just incredible structures of commerce. And they just the rooftops have caved in, that sort of thing. So what is he? So
he is not particularly interested in ruin porn, as they say.
Okay. is that what it's called?
That's right.
My wife calls me that every once in a while. I don't know why. It's not.
And we're talking. Yeah. He's interested in making good pictures.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It might be the side of a building with paint that's peeling, but it might be a picture of some brothers in their driveway, very sweet kind of portrait.
Yeah.
What I like about his photographs from this region is that he sees it clearly, but I think sensitively. He's not, I don't think, trying to make a point one way or another.
Right.
Rather, he's interested, as I say, in making good pictures. And it could be a beautiful light on leaves in the forest.
Mm-hmm.
It could be snow, which we see a lot
of. Which we do see a lot of. And you mentioned the side of the barns. A lot of times those barns had, from years ago, advertisements.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And they faded since. Mm-hmm. And it's a really cool, old-looking shot of what you know was an advertisement, but it's peeling away.
That's right.
Kind of
it is cool.
It's a cool...
The original billboard.
Yeah,
billboard. Sort of like some of our downtown Utica brick buildings.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes.
That's right.
Yeah,
yes.
Really cool.
I would say that Tommy's photographs from this exhibition definitely show the past on contemporary life. And one other thing I'd like to say is many of the color images are quite large, so it's almost cinematic. One has a feeling of being able to walk into those spaces.
Oh, that's really cool. How large is this exhibition?
There are 42
images.
And how large are the images?
The largest one is nearly 60 inches, but that's an exception. I would say most of them are 40 by 30.
Okay.
And 60 is 5 feet tall.
And this goes on through April 7th.
That's
so
correct.
You get
We're having an exhibition opening reception on this Saturday. Everyone's okay. welcome, 3 to 5. Tommy himself will come to the museum and talk about the exhibition on Sunday, March 10th.
Okay.
He's a very lively speaker. A lot of fun.
And for people, there's membership opportunities
yes.
and all of this.
Yes.
But you don't have to be a member to attend.
Oh, no. Yeah. No, not at all. Membership has its benefits, however.
Mm-hmm.
Discounts for concerts, like you were mentioning. Discounts in our pretty fabulous gift shop. And for classes. I'd also like to give a shout out to our upcoming Family Day. During President's Week, we typically have an Art Alive event on school holidays during the academic year. And this one is, I believe, a Thursday, February 21st. So if the kids are driving you crazy,
okay.
or your grandkids are with you while mom and dad are at work, do come down to the museum. There'll be lots of interesting art-making activities and lots of fun. They're typically lots of fun.
Sounds good. And, again, that show that we saw, this what that lady was able to do with a trumpet was just incredible.
I'm
really
so glad you came. Thank you.
Awesome show. So you guys do a nice job. Munson Williams, of course, there's the website. And, of course, Tommy Brown, Upstate. It's the name of the exhibition. February 9th through April 7th.
Don't wait till Easter. You'll miss it.
You will miss it. That's exactly it. When is Fat Tuesday again? Do we
don't remember.
We don't remember.
Did we say March 5th?
Retention is not one of our strongholds by any means.